היי, מה נשמע?
ג'י נמסטה.
מאיפה את?
או סליחה, which country are you from? Where are you from? אוהו, country. הם בארץ סי איי הם. מה? Oh yes, ma. It's my motherland. Lo, 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 lo. Ma means what? What? Oh, I'm from India. Yo, what an interesting country. I heard the cows walk on the road. You also have this one god out of these million gods? That has a head of an elephant. Ji bilkul. The food? Why? It is so tasty. Yeah. That I completely agree with you. What is your name? Revital. No, Zeshem Israeli. It is an Israeli name. Are you sure you don't have an Indian name?
No. This is my only name. You know, I'm actually looking for a place that serves hummus.
What did you just say?
Hummus?
Takshivi. You need to say it right, to eat it right. Hummus. Kumus. Lo. Hummus. Hummus. Ha, from the epiglottis. Hummus. Hummus. Opa! This one time, I saw Shah Rukh Khan eat hummus in Tel Aviv.
Hey guys!
What's up?
Manishma. Hey, my name is Revital. I mean, it's so weird to call myself by that name because I was always called by either Revi or Revi or Ray or I don't know. I had like a million names. I'm from India. A rather beautiful country. This is so weird. Standing right in front of a tree. It was so awkward to shoot at home because mom and dad were like, and my sister was like, awkward to speak to the camera and like, imagine there's an audience who's gonna be watching you. It's hard because my camera lens is right here, but I keep looking at myself. But then I need to be looking at you, so I need to focus on the lens, but then I wanna look at myself. Because I want to look good, but then again, I have to like, ugh, it's such a task. Anyway, I am in Israel. I've moved to Israel about 9 months. Feels like forever. Ghar jana, but what to do? It's Corona time. Why did I move? I'm Jewish. And I'm awesome. I mean, initially when I told my friends, they were like,
"Kyun?
Really? Humne tujhe itna pareshan kiya ki tu hume chhod ke ja rahi hai." It was planned for a very long time. Yeah, I ended up here. My experience has been very, I don't know what to say. I came here in March and it was Corona time, so everything was shut. I did not get a chance to explore, and it was so sad. But now everything has slowly started to open up, and now that the vaccines are gonna be out, I said it's a good opportunity for me to to explore this country, and I really wanted to be a part of it. One thing has always been consistent with me are my friends. And since all my friends are away back home in India, I said I wanted to share this with you guys so that, like, I want to feel like I'm going around with my friends and sharing information that a friend would do when they go to a new country and like have experiences. And I want to share this with my community out there. I am so excited for you guys to be a part of it, because ones who are planning to move to Israel, I mean, it's going to help you integrate in the Israeli community. And for the ones who plan to come visit me, I want you to have a memorable stay. So it's going to be awesome. What to expect from this channel? Whatever I learn and explore, right from the language, food, people, hidden gems, procedures, I want to share it with you guys, and I want you to be a part of it. I'll be quite honest with you. I mean, it's been overwhelming to live in the middle of the Middle East. I mean, it's not India. For a lot of reasons, like, it could be language, you know, right? I mean, we speak Hebrew. It was one of the dead languages, but Jews being Jews, they made an effort to get it back, and like, the entire nation speaks Hebrew. I mean, with all the Hebrew, it's beautiful, you know? It's like, it's beautiful. Obviously, there are like so many Russians here, which I love. So it's like people speak Hebrew, Russian, and then English. The mandatory army service, oh my God, I mean, I can't even imagine going to the army the time I turn 18. I mean, I'm reliving to be 18 again. If I had to serve the army for the next 2 years, that would be traumatizing. And I really look up to these people, because like, all the kids, when they turn 18, they serve the army. It's crazy. One thing Israelis are proud about is their army service. So yes, army service for sure. You know, the best part about this place is, even if people are walking by, people come and greet you. They'd be like, Shalom, or Chag Sameach, or Manishma. You know which is the part which I'm most excited about? I think for me, it's gonna be food and traveling. I think most of the time when I'm not thinking about anything, I'm only thinking about food and about aloo. Aloo is potato. By the way, batata in Hebrew means sweet potato, and batata in Marathi means potato. It's amazing. Batata vada. I clearly remember the day my group used to decide to go visit some place. Are Mumbai mein kisi bhi aise matlab, I visited that place. So we used to get so excited. I think majorly it was because of food. Sab khane milega na. Vada pav, masala dosa, misal pav, faluda, samosa, naan katai, veg pulao, chicken biryani. Oh wait, there's a funny thing, like, vegetarians call it veg biryani. I'm like, it's not veg biryani, it's pulao. You know what I miss the most? My misal pav. Sorry for saying it wrong. Misal pav. Oh my God, it's the best food that was ever invented. My friends from the north, especially from Delhi, would call it Gila Namkeen. And I'm like, listen, no. Sorry, excuse me. You can't call it that. Like, you've offended me. I'm like, it's such a beautiful dish. It's like a mixture of like two beautiful things, and that you eat with pav. Kidhar milega yaar? North mein to nahi milta hai ye sab. North mein momos milte, which is my favorite also. But misal pav for life. Any of you Israelis are watching this, and if you happen to know a restaurant that serves misal pav, please let me know. Please. I don't want to say Indian food is much better, or Israeli food is much better. I don't want to compare it, like, because I have been living in India for all my life. Obviously, I will always love Indian food, but I've started to develop a taste for Middle Eastern food, and it's amazing. Looking at so many scenarios, like a difficult language, the mandatory army service, the volatile political scenario, and especially for a person who comes from India, it's going to be culture. And in spite of so many reasons, thousands and thousands of people are moving to Israel, or are like even wanting to travel to Israel. It's amazing, like, how such a small country, like, if you actually look at the map, you can't even spot Israel on the map. You actually have to zoom in to see where actually Israel is. Such a small country, but has a very strong influence on the world. Wow. I am so excited to see what's in store for us. And I hope you're gonna be a part of my journey. And let's do this. And before you leave, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to receive notifications whenever I upload a new video. Okay, bye.